Once again, welcome back students. Today we will see one of the next topic of subject programming in C++. Seventh subject of semester 3, diploma in engineering of computer engineering department. Okay, so the first topic we start to discuss. So the learning outcome of this lecture is differentiate among different various operators that are available in C++. So to get this outcome, we will discuss the following topic. First of all, operators in C++. Second one is scope resolution operators. Third one is member dereferencing operator. And fourth one is memory management operator and manipulators. And fifth one is typecast operator. So I have divided this lecture into two parts, part one and part two. So in part one, we will discuss first three topics, operator in C++, scope resolution operator, and memory dereferencing operator. The topic fourth, memory management operator, manipulator, and typecast operator, I have made in second video of all that, that is of part two video. So in part one, we will discuss first three topics. In part two, we will discuss fourth and fifth point. Okay, so starting from operators in C++. So operators, what are operators first of all? So operators are nothing but the symbols that tells the compiler that what mathematical or logical operation that have to be done on the operands which for decide which the operators are used. So in C++, the operators are nothing but the same as in C. As you had already learned in C also, the same operators are used in C++ also. So the list of operators in C++ are, first is arithmetic operator, second one is relational operator, third is logical operator, fourth is bitwise operator, fifth assignment operator, and sixth miscellaneous operator. Okay, so starting from the first operator, that is arithmetic operators. So arithmetic operators are the operators used for mathematical operations, that is addition, subtraction, division, multiplication, modulus, that are used on integers value, double values, floating point numbers values. Okay, second one is relational operator, that used to show the relation based and they are generally used in decision making conditions. Okay, so relational operators are example of relational operator is less than, greater than, less than, equal to, greater than, equal to, equivalent, that is double equal to, and not equal to, that is not equivalent. Okay, so now the third operator is logical operator. So logical operator works on logic, as their name suggests. So first operator is AND, that is that symbol is ampersand two times. Then OR operator, double pipe, they are used to compare two conditions. Okay, so for AND, if both the condition are true, the answer will be true. And OR, if one condition is true, the answer will be true. The output will be true. Now the fourth operator is bitwise operator. So bitwise operator are working as same as logical operator, but the one of the main difference between bitwise and logical operator is that the logical operators works on expressions or operands, while the bitwise operators compares the condition having bits, or they convert the value in first into bits and decimal, and then they start compare. Okay. So the example of bitwise operator is bitwise AND operator, bitwise OR operator, bitwise XOR operator, and bitwise NOT operator. Okay, next one is assignment operator. So assignment operators are nothing but that have a shorthand notation, also referred as shorthand notation operator. So we will write plus equal to, minus equal to, like that. For assignment operator, so they are also referred as shorthand operators. So if you write a plus equal to 5, that refers a equal to a plus 5. So you are adding value 5 to a, and then again that value is stored or updated in the a variable. Okay, last, that is miscellaneous operator. So this is the last category of operator. So ternary operator, size of operators, conditional operators, that are all comes under this category. So first of all, that is size operator. Size of operator is used to check the size that is used or from the memory location in C. Second one is ampersand, used in pointer to store the address of any variable. The third is asterisk sign, also used in pointer, but it used to display the value using pointer of that variable. And the last is question mark, that is ternary or conditional operator. If you want to write if condition is true, then print this statement, or else this statement. In that case, we can use this as a shorthand operator, and we can write the whole condition in one or maximum two lines. So in those conditions, we can use this ternary operator. So these are all basically six operators are there in C++. First one is arithmetic operator, second one is logical, the third one is bitwise, then assignment, miscellaneous, and relation. So now our next topic, that is scope resolution operator. So what is scope resolution operator? So if there are two variables having the same name, one is declared as a global variable and another is declared as a local variable, and instead of using the value of that local variable, if we want to use the value of global declared variable which has the same name as this declared as local variable, then to use the value of that global variable with the same name, we can use the scope resolution operator. So the symbol of scope resolution operator is four dots as seen in the syntax, then your variable name. So with the help of the scope resolution operator, we can print the value of global variable value. Okay, let us see an example and clear the concept. Okay. So the first see the use of demonstration of the scope resolution operator. So first we had declared two header files, iostream.h and commu.h. Now here our global variable is declared with the value 10, and in main function another variable a with the same name as the global variable has the value 20. Now if we write cout a, then it prints the value of local variable, that is 20. But what we do if we want to print the value of 10 that is declared as a global value? So for that we are using the scope resolution operator. So for that if we have to write cout, then your angle brackets, then a symbol of scope resolution operator, and then a, then it prints the value of global variable, that is 10, and we get the output 2010. So 10 is 20, that is the value of your local variable, and 10 is the value of your global variable. Okay, I hope the simple program will clear your concept regarding scope resolution operator. Okay, the next topic, that is memory dereferencing operator. Now what is memory dereferencing operator? So memory dereferencing operator is nothing but an operator that is used as a pointer variable. Using pointer variable, we try to print the value of the variable whose address is stored in the pointer. That is nothing but dereferencing operator or memory dereferencing operator, that is denoted by the asterisk sign. Okay, so we will see one of the example which is shown there. So first of all, integer a equal to 7 and b, then I had declared one pointer, integer star asterisk b or star b you can say. Then p equal to ampersand of a, so we are making p as a pointer of a, so we are storing value of a in p pointer. Okay, so then I will try to store the value of a into b using this memory dereferencing operator. So I write b equal to star of p, so star of p will always display the value of a as it is the pointer of variable a. So b equal to star p. So this statement b equal to star p is a main part which shows the use of memory dereferencing operator. So in this way we can print the value of a variable, or the variable whose address is stored by the pointer. Using pointer, we have to write star pointer name, we were able to print the value of that variable. Okay. So in this lecture we had discussed about the operators in C++, that are arithmetic operator, relational operator, logical operator, bitwise operator, then your assignment operator, and last is the miscellaneous operator. And then we discussed about the scope resolution operator, that is four dots used to print the value of a global variable whose name is same as local variable. And last we discussed about memory dereferencing operator, that is a pointer variable used to print the value of the variable whose address is stored by the pointer using the asterisk sign, that is star p or star pt, whatever your pointer variable name is, depend on that. Okay, so I hope the part one of this lecture is clear. Now we will you have to watch part two, in that we will discuss the remaining two topics to achieve our learning outcome of this lecture. Okay, thank you students for watching this lecture.